What's up, collectors? Back again. This time with a review of the Designer Series X Mega Man X by TruForce Collectibles. I will score this up based on my opinions, and I can already tell you that it is pretty good. The first category I'm going to score this on is the source information. I can already tell you that I grew up playing the Mega Man X on Super Nintendo. And I can already tell you that the games were always among my favorites growing up as a kid. I played pretty much every Mega Man X game, except for the later ones that came out on the PS2. I think it was Mega Man X 7 and 8. Never got around to actually playing those. I stopped at 6. But Mega Man X, it's not the actual Mega Man. As fans probably already know, this is a... The X version was based off the... future takes place. It's the same universe, it's just a future Mega Man takes care of pretty much robots who have gone bad, known as a Maverick Hunter or a regular Hunter. Really good story. If you read into it or play any of the games, it's pretty awesome. So, as for the source information, I'm gonna give that a 10 out of 10. Alright, stick with me, and we're gonna score up the rest. Alright, now we've reached the category of the packaging, and I gotta tell you, this box is really cool. It's not really a picture of the figure on the front, it's more of a artwork, but it is still of the figure, but still cool. As you can see, it says right there, Designer Series X. And on the top left corner, it says TruForce Collectibles Designer Series. And there's the figure itself. And on the side, you get kind of like, I don't know how really to describe it. It's like more artwork, but it's done in like a glossy background finish, I guess. It kind of blends into the background. The only reason you can see it now is because the light is directly hitting it. And then on the top, you got the Mega Man X logo. And on the other side, you get another holographic design, just like on the other side, but this one is of the front of Mega Man. And on the back, you get a brief description of the company. And you can pause it if you want, so you can read it. And then in the background, you get a close-up of Mega Man again, firing off a charged shot. And in the center, you get three more poses of the figure. And on the bottom, it pretty much describes what it comes with, the accessories and such. And you can open up the front to reveal the window of the figure, and that's where the figure would be. But as you probably already know, I already took them out. And on the other side of the panel, we get some more artwork of the figure. I believe this was prototype artwork before the figure came out, as like a teaser. And it pretty much describes all of his robotic parts. And right there you get a little message from the designer company themselves. So really nice. So I'd say on the packaging, it's very cleverly designed. I do like the artwork. So I'm gonna go ahead and give that I'm gonna give it an 8 out of 10. Alright, stick with me and we'll move on to the other categories. Alright, so now we are moving on into the category of likeness. And I don't think I have to tell you, it is pretty spot on. I mean, given the fact that it is an animation, but still, True Collectibles did a pretty good job on that. And not only that, it not only gives you one likeness of Mega Man, but it also gives you a second one with the pretty much used for the blaster poses, or I'm sorry, the X-Buster poses when he's firing off his shots. And both poses are pretty good too. I don't have any complaints about either of them. And that's all I gotta say about the likeness. Alright, so stick with me and we shall move on to the next categories. Alright, so now we're moving on to the category of articulation. and it's got pretty good articulation. It ain't too bad. I really like the double jointed knees and the double jointed elbows. And you can tell right here, look at how far back the knee will bend. It'll go pretty much all the way back to his back. Same goes for the elbows. They'll pretty much bend all the way back to his head. As for the hip area of the legs, it's kind of hard to bend that area. I don't know, maybe it's because it's new, but it's kind of hard. I was having difficulties putting him in the poses that I wanted, but it's not too bad. He's got rotation in the hip area, or the lower torso, the upper torso also. He's got a ball joint in the neck, so he can pretty much do a 360 turn, move up and down. It's pretty good at moving up and down. You can get really, really far down or really far up with the head movement. The thighs are die-cast. The ankles, they'll move a little bit, but not too much. There's one thing I forgot to mention. He's got all these little detailed markings all over his body. Like little words. It's not gonna focus. Sorry about that, guys. But yeah. Right there it says caution. And right there, you can't really see because it's got reflection of the light. But it says propellant inside right there. And right in the middle of his chest, right there, it says irregular hunter. That's my favorite marking right there. It's pretty cool. And he's pretty much got it like all over his body, different wordings. Like right there, it says beware of blast. And here's another thing I forgot to mention. The bottom of his boots, really detailed. Like you'd think he'd have the thrusters coming out of there, ready to blast off. And right there, like close to his wrist, he's also got another caution warning there. And then right there on his back, he's got wording that says energy tank inside. So, pretty good. Pretty much got him in a running pose to demonstrate his articulation. It's pretty iconic of Mega Man, because he's always running in the game wherever you got him going. But stick with me, guys, and we'll move on to the next category. Alright, we've reached the final category, which is accessories. And as you can see, it comes with a whole lot. It comes with the see-through base, as you can see right there, with two arms for holding the figure. Here's the other one. It comes with the X-Buster, with the LED light. Give me 1 second, guys. Turn that on for you. There you go. And it's really bright. Complements the figure very nicely. It's pretty cool. I'm still blown away by that. And it also comes with four hands. When it comes out of the box, it's wearing two fists. And the other two are spread hands. And then it also comes with an extra face sculpt. As you can see there. It comes with two extra back exhausts to complete the dashing pose. And then this is another thing that kind of blew me away as well, was the back or the leg thrusters for completing the dashing pose. If you guys remember the game, he'd be dashing all the time. I know I was always spamming that. It just brings back a lot of nostalgia for me. And then it also comes, the other main thing of this figure is the X-Buster blast effects. This one here is the regular shot. And this, if you guys remember in the beginning of the review, it's like the flash of the blast effect from the X-Buster. So that just goes like around the front of the X-Buster. And here is the charge shot. If you guys remember in the beginning of the review, he actually had this on for the first pose. It is really nice. And it also looks very well when you have the LED on with these effects on. It looks really nice. And it also comes with the instruction manual for the batteries for the X-Buster. It tells you how to install them. And it also comes with the regular instruction manual, pretty much telling you how to use the base and how the arms on the base work and how to install the back thrusters. Tells you how to put the arm on, the X-Buster arm on. But yeah, that's pretty much everything it comes with. Now, as for anything else to think that it needs, I don't think there's anything else. I would have said that it needs another face sculpt, but it's already got that covered. So, I don't think, in my mind, I don't think it needs anything else. So, yeah, for the accessories, I'm going to give it a 10 out of 10. And if you were watching the beginning of the review, I gave the source information a 10 out of 10. But as for the rest of the categories, I didn't give them a score, so I'm going to go ahead and score it up right now. The likeness is also a 10 out of 10. And the articulation, I'm going to give that a 7 out of 10. And as you already know, I already gave the accessories a 10 out of 10, so it brings the score to a 37 out of 40. And that is a pretty good score. It might be due to the fact that I am partial to Mega Man X also. And I'm just going to go ahead and close off with this final pose. As you can see, he's dashing. I tried to go for that iconic look that we always see him in the video game. It sure brings back memories. Very nostalgic of this game. Alright guys, and that's it. I hope you liked that review. And please like the video. And hope to see you again in the future. Alright, take care guys. Bye.